Hello students, now I am going to start glycolysis, which is part of the new CBCS syllabus of semester 2, paper number CC7, biochemistry paper, and it is also part of the BSc Honors Zoology course, part 3. So I am coming to the topic directly. The glycolytic pathway. Glycolysis is a series of metabolic processes by which one molecule of glucose is catabolized into two molecules of pyruvate with a net gain of 2 ATP. The equation will be like this: one glucose molecule plus 2 inorganic phosphates plus 2 ADP plus 2 NAD plus gives 2 pyruvate, 2 ATP plus 2 NADH plus 2 protons and 2 molecules of water. Glycolytic pathway is also known as the Embeden-Meyerhof pathway, which has two phases, the priming phase and the energy yielding phase. As illustrated in the figure which is shown, you can see that whole pathway. The red color indicates the transfer of phosphate group from one compound to another compound. You can see that the phosphate group is getting transferred from ATP to glucose in the priming phase. And in the yielding phase, you will see the phosphate group will come back to the ATP molecule giving rise to ATP molecule. So I will come to the detail of these pathways. So first, in the priming phase, that uses two molecule of ATPs to convert glucose to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate through sequential reactions catalyzed by enzymes hexokinase, phosphoglucose isomerase and phosphofructokinase. In the second phase, fructose fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is further converted stepwise into pyruvate with the production of 4 molecules of ATP and 2 molecules of NADH. During this process, 2 ADP and 2 NAD plus are consumed in the absence of oxygen. NAD plus is regenerated from NADH by reduction of pyruvate to lactic acid, catalyzed by lactate dehydrogenase. Under aerobic conditions, pyruvate can be further oxidized to CO2 and H2O in the mitochondria through the tricarboxylic cycle, popularly known as Krebs cycle or TCA cycle, and the respiratory chain, yielding large amount of ATP. As you can see in this figure, that each reaction in the glycolytic pathway is catalyzed by a specific enzyme or enzyme complex. In addition to their well-characterized enzymatic activities, recent studies suggest that some of the glycolytic enzymes are multifunctional proteins. For instance, hexokinase, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase, or short form is GAPDH, and enolase have been implicated to play a role in transcriptional. These enzymes have also role in the transcriptional regulation. For example, hexokinase and GAPDH may regulate apoptosis, and glucose 6-phosphate isomerase can affect cell motility. Furthermore, although glycolysis is the classical metabolic pathway that generates pyruvate, other metabolic reactions such as conversion of xylulose 5-phosphate to glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate also occurs through the pentose-phosphate pathway by transketolase and produce the metabolic intermediate that channel to the second phase of the glycolytic pathway, yani paying phase, okay, yielding pyruvate and ATP. Interestingly, overexpression of the transketolase enzyme, like enzyme, in cancer cells has recently been reported. And here I will come to the enzymes which are important, which are the key enzymes in the glycolysis. Okay. First enzyme is hexokinase. The ATP dependent phosphorylation of glucose to form glucose 6-phosphate is the first and rate limiting reaction in glycolysis and is catalyzed by tissue specific isoenzymes known as hexokinases. This phosphorylation converts the non-ionic glucose to an anion, yani G-6P, that is trapped in the cells. Glucose 6-phosphate serves as the starting point of the for the sugar to enter the glycolytic pathway or the pentose phosphate pathway. What happens here is, once the glucose enters in the cell, immediately it gets converted into glucose 6-phosphate by the hexokinase enzyme. If this conversion takes place, then glucose cannot move out of the cell. Phosphorylation makes it impermeable for the plasma membrane to go into the extracellular matrix again. Okay, so the starting point of the sugar to enter the glycolytic pathway or the pentose phosphate pathway or for the glycogen synthesis, 4 mammalian isoenzymes of hexokinase type 1 to type 4 have been identified. And these are tissue specific also, with the type 4 isoenzymes often referred to the glucokinase and found in hepatocytes, means the liver cells. Glucokinase has a higher Km value for the glucose than other isoenzymes. The regulation of hexokinase and glucokinase activities is also different. Hexokinase 1, 2 and 3 are allosterically inhibited by product accumulation. Means, as the product means glucose 6-phosphate accumulate, then these enzymes or the different types of hexokinase 1, 2, 3 can be inhibited allosterically, where glucokinase are not. These enzyme properties favor glucose storage in the liver. That's why the glucose is stored in the liver, because glucokinase cannot be allosterically inhibited by the accumulation of glucose 6-phosphate in the liver during times of glucose excess and peripheral glucose utilization. Hexokinases are 100 kilodalton molecules thought to have evolved by duplication and fusion of a gene encoding an ancestral 50 kilodalton hexokinase. Thus, these isoenzymes display internal sequence repetition, and the amino and carboxyl terminal halves have extensive sequence similarity. These several studies demonstrate that the hexokinase, particularly type 2 isoform, plays a critical role in initiating and maintaining the high glucose catabolic rates of rapidly growing tumors. Most immortalized and malignant cells display increased expression of hexokinase type 2, which might contribute to elevated glycolysis. At the genetic level, certain tumor cells exhibit increased gene copy number of type 2 hexokinase. At the transcriptional level, the gene promoter shows a wide promiscuity towards multiple signals activated by glucose, insulin, hypoxic conditions, and forbitol esters. Okay. all of which enhances the rate of transcription. It has also been suggested that the tumor suppressor P53 may be involved in regulating hexokinase gene transcription. At the protein level, hexokinases are either free in the cytosol or bound to the mitochondrial outer membrane. The mitochondria bound hexokinase seems to have the advantage of using ATP produced by the oxidative phosphorylation as the substrate to phosphorylate glucose. Means as soon as the ATP, because this makes the availability of ATP to the hexokinase in close proximity. As soon as the ATP comes out of the mitochondria, then and there is an ample supply of the glucose, hexokinase uses that ATP to convert glucose into the glucose 6-phosphate. It was estimated that approximately 70% of the cellular hexokinase is associated with mitochondria under basal metabolic conditions. These findings suggest that oxidative phosphorylation may be efficiently coupled to the glycolytic pathway via mitochondrial bound hexokinase. Furthermore, hexokinase binds to the outer mitochondrial membrane at sites where the voltage-dependent anion channel, VDAC, is located. This places the complex in close association with the adenine nucleotide translocator or ANT, which spans the inner mitochondrial membrane and facilitates the exchange of cytoplasmic ADP for mitochondrial ATP. Since recent studies suggest that VDAC or ANT may play an important role in regulating mitochondrial permeability transition and release of apoptotic factors such as cytochrome C, it is suspected that hexokinase may also participate in the apoptotic pathway. Correct? For instance, mitochondrial hexokinase activity seems to be required for the growth factor induced cell survival, and AKT or protein kinase B signaling appears to promote the association of hexokinase with BDAC on the mitochondrial membrane and enhance the mitochondrial hexokinase activity, leading to inhibition of apoptosis. The molecular mechanism underlying the anti-apoptotic effect of hexokinase is still unclear. AKT-mediated activation of mitochondrial hexokinase seems to inhibit cytochrome C release and apoptosis by antagonizing the pro-apoptotic function of TBID, which is an activator of apoptotic molecules BAX and BAK. Analysis of mitochondrial protein complexes has revealed that glucokinase, a type 4 hexokinase expressed predominantly in liver, is presented in a mitochondrial complex that contains another VDAC interacting protein BAD. BAD is a pro-apoptotic BCL2 family member that induces apoptosis by inhibiting the anti-apoptotic molecule, that is BCLX1. Transgenic mice expressing non-phosphorylated BAD display apparently reduced mitochondrial glucokinase activity and reduced glucose tolerance, a condition found in diabetes. Thus, it appears that hexokinase and its association with mitochondrial protein complex may play important role in the essential homeostatic processes such as glucose metabolism and apoptosis. Inhibition of this enzyme is likely to have profound effects on cellular energy metabolism and survival. Thus, hexokinase is an attractive target for anti-cancer agents. The second important enzyme is glucose 6-phosphate isomerase. The interconversion of G6P and fructose 6-phosphate is catalyzed by phosphoglucose isomerase, which plays an important role in both the glycolytic and gluconeogenesis pathway. Interestingly, Recent studies have revealed that GPI can also function as an autocrine motility factor, which is secreted from the tumor cells to promote cell motility and proliferation. Autocrine motility factor and its receptor were originally identified in melanoma and oncogene transfer metastatic NS3T3 cells, and the AMFR interaction seems to stimulate tumor cell migration in vitro and enhance metastasis and angiogenesis in vivo. Autocrine motility factor receptor is overexpressed in various metastatic tumors and is correlated with a poor prognosis. The presence of GPI in serum and urine is also associated with cancer progression and indicates poor prognosis. Why I am giving importance to the cancer or the apoptosis in these things, that because these are the recent findings about the glycolytic enzymes involved in the glycolytic pathway. For exam purpose, for exam point of view, these informations are not that much necessary. Only you have to memorize the glycolytic pathway, which is shown on the display. I will describe, I'll explain that pathway once again in the summary section. So, coming to that point, the presence of GPI in serum and urine is associated with cancer progression and indicates poor prognosis. As I already told, the expression of PGI is stimulated by hypoxia, and in addition to its well-defined enzymatic activity in the glycolytic pathway, GPI also functions as a cytokine extracellularly and is associated with aggressive malignant behaviors. The next enzyme is phosphofructokinase. This enzyme catalyzes the rate limiting phosphorylation of fructose 6-phosphate. This is an important point in the regulation of glycolytic pathway. So this enzyme, phosphofructokinase, this enzyme catalyzes the rate limiting phosphorylation of glucose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Using ATP as the energy source, phosphofructokinase is allosterically regulated by 2,3-diphosphoglycerate, or short form is DPG. Three forms of phosphofructokinase, that is M means it is found in muscle, L it is found in liver, and P which is found in platelets, have been identified in humans. And the involvement of phosphofructokinase in cancer is unclear still. The next enzyme is aldolase. Aldolase catalyzes the reversible conversion of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate to glyceraldehyde. Aldolase catalyzes the reversible conversion of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Means in the paying off phase, where glucose is converted, the 6-carbon compound is converted through a series of metabolic pathway intermediates, which I have described earlier, the hexokinase, using the enzyme hexokinase and others, one glucose molecule, the 6-carbon molecule, is converted into the 2,3-carbon molecule. Molecule compound. So, one is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and another one is dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate further goes in the glycolytic pathway, and dihydroxyacetone phosphate is converted back into the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and then it is utilized. So, aldolase, this conversion is done by the enzyme aldolase, and aldolase is a tetramer of identical subunits of 40 kilodalton each. Three distinct isoenzymes, particularly named as A, B, and C, have been identified. Interestingly, this enzyme becomes elevated in the serum of patients with certain malignant tumors. Proteome analysis indicates that this enzyme is overexpressed in human lung squamous carcinoma. The next enzyme is glyceraldehyde phosphate dehydrogenase. This is an important enzyme. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase is well known as a classical glycolytic enzyme encoded by a housekeeping gene, which is constitutively expressed in most cells. This enzyme catalyzes an essential redox reaction in the glycolytic pathway. Conversion of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate coupled with the reduction of NAD plus to NADH. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase is unique among the glycolytic enzymes because of its ability to bind NAD plus or NADH and also to DNA and RNA. This unique property enables this protein to affect multiple cellular processes, including endocytosis, membrane fusion, vesicular secretion, nuclear transfer RNA transport, and DNA replication and repair. Nuclear GAPDH forms an OCT1 transcriptional co-activator complex. OCAS, these informations are not in your syllabus, but I want to give you an extra information regarding how these enzymes are related with the cancer and apoptosis. So nuclear GAPDH forms an OCT1 transcriptional co-activator complex, and OCAS, which is an S-phase dependent transactivator of the gene encoding histone S2B. And the DNA binding property of GAPDH is enhanced when the NAD plus ratio is low. NADH to NAD plus ratio is low, leading to enhanced OCA activity and H2B expression, means histone S2B expression. When NADH to NAD plus ratio is low, then H2B plus expression increases. Interestingly, GADPH is implicated in apoptosis when it is translocated into the nucleus. Although the molecular mechanism responsible for its nuclear translocation and its role in cancer remain to be defined, this is not clearly understood still. So, the next enzyme is phosphoglycerate kinase. This enzyme catalyzes the conversion of 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate to 3-phosphoglycerate coupled with the generation of ATP from ADP. Two isoenzymes of phosphoglycerate kinase have been identified. Phosphoglycerate kinase 1 is ubiquitously expressed in somatic cells, whereas phosphoglycerate kinase 2 seems to be expressed only in spermatozoa. Phosphoglycerate kinase consists of two domains that are connected by a conjugate hinge with the ADP to ATP binding site located in the C-terminal domain and the phosphoglycerate binding site in the N-terminal domain. Okay, so a conformational rearrangement involving bending of the hinge occurs upon binding of both substrates. Okay, so bringing them in the position for phosphate transfer. So the next enzyme is phosphoglycerate mutase. The glycolytic enzyme phosphoglycerate mutase catalyzes the interconversion of glycerate 3-phosphate and glycerate 2-phosphate. Phosphoglycerate mutase requires deglycerate 2,3-diphosphate for activation by donating one of its phosphoryl groups to form a covalently linked phosphoryl enzyme. A recent study using proteome analysis showed that this enzyme seems to be differentially overexpressed in human lung squamous carcinoma. Enolase enzyme, the next enzyme. The enolase catalyzes द कन्वर्जन ऑफ टू फॉस्फोग्लिसरेट टू फॉस्फोइनोलपायरुवेट. द एंजाइम इज हाईली कंजर्व्ड एंड टिश्यू स्पेसिफिक आइसोफॉर्म्स आर फाउंड इन माइनर काइनेटिक डिफरेंसेस with minor kinetic differences. So different isoforms of this enzyme, and this enzyme is tissue specific, but there is a little difference in their kinetic behavior. So three major isoforms of enolases have been identified in mammals. The alpha isoform is expressed in fetal cells and the other adult cell types. The beta isoform is expressed in striated muscle and the gamma isoform is neuron specific. The expression of enolase is regulated both developmentally and tissue specifically, but the enzyme kinetic properties of all isoenzymes are similar. A recent proteome analysis showed that alpha enolase is overexpressed in human lung squamous carcinoma. The next enzyme is pyruvate kinase. Pyruvate kinase catalyzes the irreversible phosphoryl group transfer from phosphoenolpyruvate to ADP, yielding pyruvate and ATP. Pyruvate is an essential metabolic intermediate that channels into several metabolic pathways. Pyruvate kinase is a tetramer that is allosterically activated by phosphoenolpyruvate and negatively regulated by the concentration of ATP. Okay, so interestingly, tumor cells in particular express the PK phosphoenolkinase isoenzyme type M2, which seems to regulate the proportion of glucose carbons for synthetic processes of glycolytic energy production. The dimeric form of M2 PK is present predominantly in tumor cells, known as tumor M2 PK, and such dimerization appears to be caused by direct interaction of M2PK with certain oncoproteins. This regulatory mechanism is thought to allow tumor cells to survive in an environment with varying oxygen and nutrients. The next enzyme is lactate dehydrogenase. The lactate dehydrogenase is not actually a glycolytic pathway enzyme. It falls out of the glycolytic pathway, but I want to explain it here because it converts pyruvate into the lactate, the last step. So the lactate dehydrogenase enzyme is a tetramer of A and B subunits encoded by two separate genes. This enzyme catalyzes the conversion of pyruvate to lactate coupled with an oxidation of NADH to NAD+, which is essential for the glycolytic pathway. Interestingly, LDHA gene is controlled by hypoxia inducible factor. Short form is hypoxia inducible factor HIF 1 alpha, whereas LDHB gene is not regulated by low oxygen. In addition to its essential role in glucose metabolism, LDHA isoform has been identified as a single-stranded DNA binding protein. Lactate dehydrogenase 5 was also identified as a DNA helix destabilizing protein and speculated to be involved in transcription. Correct? The binding of LDHA to single-stranded DNA is inhibited by NADH, which induces conformational change and modulates the DNA binding activity of LDH. More recently, biochemical studies suggest that LDHA and LDHB are components of a cell cycle dependent transcriptional coactivator. And these unexpected observations indicate that a fraction of LDH might participate in DNA replication and RNA transcription. So, this concludes about the various enzymes which takes part in glycolysis. Now I will come to explain you the figure here, the glycolysis, the metabolic pathway. So till now you have seen this figure. These are the enzymes. So the first first intermediate, the substrate you can say, is glucose, 6-carbon compound, and 1 ATP is used here. In the presence of enzyme hexokinase, it is converted into the glucose 6-phosphate. So, and the next enzyme is phosphoglucose isomerase. So, this phosphoglucose isomerase, what it does is, it converts glucose 6-phosphate into fructose 6-phosphate. So, the phosphate group here you can see is indicated red in color. And the next enzyme is phosphofructokinase, and again 1 ATP is used here. So, it is giving rise to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. So, one phosphate group is at carbon number 1, another phosphate group is at carbon number 6. And next enzyme is fructose bisphosphate enolase, which converts, which breaks down this 6-carbon compound into 2-3-carbon compounds. One is dihydroxyacetone phosphate, which does not take part in the glycolysis pathway, but it is interchangeable with the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So, here you can see that one glucose molecule is converted into 2 glyceraldehyde 3-phosphates. So, now, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzymes comes into the action. So, here 2 NAD plus, because it is one glucose gives rise to 2 glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So, you can read it as 2 NAD plus plus 2 inorganic phosphate molecules gets converted into or get reduced into 2 NADH plus plus 2 proton. Now, and giving rise to the intermediate, which is called as 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate under the action of phosphoglycerate kinase gives rise to, or it phosphorylates by the transfer of this phosphate group to the ADP, and there is a production of ATP. So, here you can see there are 2 ATP molecules which are produced, because this is 2,3-carbon compound. So, again, glyceraldehyde phosphokinase ke baad, phosphoglycerate mutase enzymes comes into the action, which converts 3-phosphoglycerate into 2-phosphoglycerate, and then enolase enzyme, one water molecule comes out, and enolase enzyme converts 2-phosphoglycerate into the phosphoenolpyruvate. Phosphoenolpyruvate, with the help of enzyme pyruvate kinase, gives rise to pyruvate, and during this reaction 1 ATP is generated. You can say 2 ATP is generated. Okay, so 2 ADP molecule gets converted into 2 ATP molecule. So you can summarize this whole reaction as there is net total gain of 2 ATP molecules and 2 NADH plus H plus molecule. So, here I conclude the glycolysis part. In next part, we will discuss about gluconeogenesis and other topics. Okay, thanks a lot.